Hello guys, I'm Video Guy, and this is the first episode of Game Maker Studio. So in this episode I want to show you my games I've created with Game Maker Studio. I'm gonna show you a few because I have a lot of projects and they're all prototypes, so it's not really complete. Some are more complete than the others, but yes, I'm gonna show you a few, and then hopefully it will be really good and you're gonna like it, I hope. So also what I want to do is give you a little bit of a tutorial and show you around and how it's working, and to get you a little bit more knowledge about how to make a game and how I go into the progress of making a game. So for the first game I want to show you, it is a parking game. So you have a car and you go around the parking lot or a little city, and then you can park the car. And yeah, I want to show you that, and then I show you the game first, and then after I showed you the game I'm gonna show you some code of it and how it works. I think that will be interesting. So this is the project I opened up. At the bottom here you see the output. That's everything that the program is doing. So if I gonna run the game, it's gonna compile and it's gonna output it to the outputter right here. So basically you can also do some debug text inputs in the code itself. So if the code runs, you can see it in the output file. But that's for a later video, but that's just a way to find problems in your game or tell something or see when it's gonna execute. So but first of what I want to say is I'm not really a professional in this, so if I say something that's not really correct, or I show you something and I and it's not working or something, I'm not a professional, I'm just showing you what I've made, so don't be too too exciting right now. So the graphics are also not really good because I cannot do graphics, but yeah, I'm trying my best. So this is my little parking game. So basically this thingy right here is your speed meter. And then you see your speed right here and your gears. You can switch gears. You see right here that your handbrake is on, and you can do it on and off. Also the engine. You see the damage. You can get 5 times damage and then the game will reset. Also I've got the fuel meter. So yeah, basically that's it. So the car is in the middle. You see I've got an NPC car driving around. So basically how this game works, you see these red boxes you can park in. So if I'm gonna start the engine and put off the parking brake and go into first gear, I can drive and I can try to drive into this parking thingy. So also if you look at the lights, the brake lights are working, and I can brake a little bit and I can give gas a little bit. So it's just like a real car, and you can also turn a little bit slowly. You see, if you if you press a little bit and then yeah, you can do that. So I'm now in reverse, so you see the lights are right. So you have more than 4 gears, you have actually 5 gears, and the car goes really fast if you use it in 5th gear. So you see how the game works a little bit. So basically the arrows on the ground are the way you can drive in. So basically that's, it's not one way only, it's just a way you can drive in. And then the speed meters right here, so this circle with the 6 in it, you can drive what you call it, the speed of 6. So if I'm in first gear, I'm only gonna drive 3 speed. So if I go to second gear, the fastest speed I can do is 6 speed. So that's just the markings on the ground. Also, I've got multiple cars in this game. So I've got this this smart car, the mini car. Also, I've got a normal car, and also you can drive in a bus. So I'm gonna go into reverse and reverse this car. So you see it's yellow, and I've not completed this yet because I need to go in a neutral mode. So I'm now in neutral, and then I put on the parking brake, put off my engine, and it's green. And then if I press enter, I'm successfully did the level. And it resets the game. So now you can see I'm in the bus. So it's totally random in which vehicle you're gonna drive. So the bus is a little bit slower, and you can steer a little bit slower, and it all works a little bit slower, and you're much bigger than normal vehicles. So I've got also a bus station. I don't actually know where it is, because I've really not playing this game in a long time. I think it's here. Yeah, it's here. So, no, it's not here. Wait, it's down here. Yeah, it's the bus round right here. So, come on, bus. Yeah. So, basically, the driving system is actually pretty realistic, I think. Because if I'm going in fifth gear and I press W or the up arrow, I cannot drive because I'm into in a too high gear for the car to work. So if I'm in second gear, I can also not go forward, only in first. And if I go like 5 gears and I stop, I cannot drive anymore. So it's pretty realistic. Also, the fuel meter will go down, and it will go down a little bit when you have your engine on, and it will go go down even more when you are driving at a higher speed and on a higher gear. Also, I've got a fuel pump, so you can go and refuel your fuel meter. And so now I'm going to try and park this big vehicle. So the only problem with the bus at this moment is you cannot really see the color of the ground. So I don't actually know if I'm done right now. Yeah, it worked. So this is the other car. It's actually pretty good that I see this car already. So it's totally random when I've got the car. So you see, it's driving a little bit faster than the smart car, and oh, I've bounced to the wall. So you see the damage also gone up. So now I can show you the refuel center. So it's right here. You see this little box right here. So if I stand in it and I put off my engine, parking brake on, and go in neutral modus, I can refuel with enter key. So you see, look at my fuel meter, you see it go up. So that's only when I stand right here, and I think that's really cool actually. And then you can just drive further, you don't have to pay anything. I wish that was in real life. Would be really cool to have that, but yeah, I know why it's not free. So this basically this parking game, and yeah, it's basically that. So to show you more of this game, how it's working, I'm gonna explain you how it works. So we've got sprites right here, and sprites are every graphics what the game is gonna show. Then you have tile sets, and that's also graphics. But tile sets are like little tiles you can make, And then, for example, like this, you see like the ground is divided in tiles, and I can just place the tiles into the room. And the room right here is the game. This is the game level. And then if you have a look right here, this everything is a tile. So if I go to ground, you see that I can just place it on the ground like a block. So it's really easy. Also, the NPC's cars are driving on this line. So one car is the blue car, and it's driving around this circle you see right here. And then also I've got the pink car right here that's driving around this circle. And then the rest of the game is just parking spaces right here. And these are the parking spots. So everything is separate. I can just place it right here and the parking place is there. So it's really easy to edit all this. And also all the pink stuff right here, that's the collisions. And the collisions are basically walls. So if the car goes into this collision, it's gonna stop and give you damage. So this is exactly how it's actually working. And then you can go more in detail and have right here at the bottom you see viewports, and these are just this is the window of your game. So it's basically you have your window of the game. It's 720p right now, and then you have the camera position. The camera is separate from your game window, so you can zoom in on the car and then have like a view around it. So you see like this white circle around here, and that's basically the camera that's looking at your vehicle, and it's gonna move with the vehicle around the map. And then your window is the size I make it right here. So that's basically that part of the system. So you see the graphics, how it's working, and you see like the game, how you make it in a level. So basically the only thing you don't know now is the NPCs, the objects. So basically I've got the object car right here, and this car has some events in it. So you've got the step event, and the step event is basically every second it's gonna check for all of this code right here. And then when I kind of set up the keys here, so this is for all the keys I use in the game, and then I can check it when I press the key. And then I can check here for the direction of the car. So the default direction is always the direction minus 90, so I can always look from left to right basically. And the image angle is the image of the car, so the car is 90 degrees in the direction. So right here I'm gonna check for the view. I need to check that every frame because it needs to update. So the car view is less than zero, so I've have not a view anymore. Then the car view is zero and the engine is off because you cannot drive with no view. And I don't really need to put this right here because it's already off, but I put this right here because if you notice right here, it's less or equals zero. So if it's less than zero and I don't do this right here, then it's maybe minus minus 20 or something, and then I could have some problems when it's minus 20 if I check on other stuff. So that's always why I put it at zero. So if we go right here, you see basically the green text is explaining what the code underneath it is gonna do. And that's really good learning curve. So if you start programming, always comment your programming. So because if I look at this from a year further right now, I can see this and I know what it's gonna do. So if I look at right here, drop the fuel, I see the fuel is gonna drop when the engine is on, and it's gonna drop with the car fuel drop speed of the half of it. So I know that it's now doing that. So if I didn't comment this this all, and I go into a year later and I look at this code, I don't know anymore how it's all gonna work. So that's really difficult. So always comment your code, so you you always know what it's gonna do. So basically minus equals means if the car fuel is 100 and minus equals the car drop speed, and the car drop speed is like 50, it's after this frame it's 50. So it's subtracting from the car fuel. And then you have plus equals, and that's basically the other way around. And then you have also right here. So basically equals equals means if the car engine is on, or car engine. So let's say this value is now off. So the engine is off from the car. So this is false. So basically what I say is if false equals false, then do this code. So if this is on, like say it's true, so this value is true. So if true equals equals false, then do not do this code. So it's checking. This is a checking way to check. So yeah, you can check the code state of it. I hope I can explain it good. I don't know. So if I press the key gear up, and the key gear up is right here, that is keyboard check press W. So if I press the W key, this is gonna be true. If I don't press it in this frame, it's gonna be false. So if it's true right here, then the car gear is gonna be going up with one gear. But that's only going up when the car gear is less than the car max gear. So yeah, I think that's explained good. So yeah, I hope you can understand it. I don't know if I'm really good in explaining this, but I hope I do. It's my first time. So basically, right here you have another thing you can check for. So you see, like, if the left key is pressed, the car turn speed is zero. Or, because this means or, if the right key is pressed, then the car turn speed is also zero. So if you press both of these keys, just this or just that, it's gonna do the same. But every other key, it's not gonna do this. So it's only between this one. So yeah, I think that's explained good. So that's basically a little bit into the programming side of it, of this project. So you know a little bit how it works. So also I've got right here, these are childs from the parents. So basically this object is a parent object or from the bus, the car, and the other car. So I don't have to program a lot of cars. I only program one car and use multiple cars for the same car. So if this car is gonna be like different, it's so I've basically, I can explain it better. So basically if this car speed, so speed up speed, so the speed up speed is basically the acceleration of the car. So the mini car, if the acceleration is 0.05, and I make now like another car, I don't want to have that the same acceleration speed. I want that maybe to have a better acceleration speed. I can just change this to like maybe 99 or something, and then this car is faster in acceleration than this car. So I only have to code the basics of the car, and the other knowledge about the car is doing the main object car. So I save a lot of time with this, and I think that's really great. And you learn all that from having loads of experience. Because otherwise you need to make every car, and you need to duplicate it and change things. But this is much more efficient. So yeah, basically this is the park your car game. Now I'm gonna show you a different game that's much further in development. Alright, this is Worlds Battles. So basically this is a game that I've made not too long ago, and this is actually a really good game, because it has a lot of mechanics and systems I've worked on for a long time. So basically what I did is made a lot of little projects and did focus on one thing. So like, I want to have a game with daily rewards. So I want to have a system with daily rewards. So I've made a program that's only focusing on a daily reward system that I can copy and paste on every future project I have. So I did that with a lot of stuff, and now I'm gonna show you the game itself. So this is a game that was focused for mobile and PC. And it's basically a turn-based game. So you see, I have a daily reward system. It's day 2 now. That's because my save game is still intact. So basically, it's day 2 in this game. So you see, I've got some diamonds and some coins, and then download or game for a bonus. And I don't know. So if you this message just means if you have this on your mobile phone and you download my other games on your mobile phone, this program, this daily reward system, is gonna look in your phone if you have my games installed. And if you have all my games installed, it's gonna give you an extra bonus for it. So that's the daily reward system. So every day of the week you have a daily reward, and it's gonna be better after each week. So yeah, that's really cool. So this is basically a map of the whole world, and then you have like this is tutorial world. You see, like, you can give stars to the world. That's how good you done that level. I've got much more levels right here, but they're not showing up now because I'm still in the tutorial. So I've got XP right here, and this minimum XP and this maximum. And then if I have more than the maximum, I'm gonna go level up. And then I've got power, and this is the main power of my character with all the things combined. So this is my power from my profile. This is my profile name. I'm level 2 at the moment. You see my diamonds. And you see my coins and my tickets. Tickets are used for levels. So every level needs like 2 tickets or something. And then if you're out of tickets, you cannot do levels anymore. It's like a little bit Candy Crush. Because Candy Crush also has like that system. These are... I've got 41 Y coins. Y is just equals, it just means like I've got more than a billion and a trillion coins of that. So it's like you have a few thousands, and then you go in the millions and the trillions and the billions. So it's just a currency calculation. I also have got more tabs right here. So you have like the world, you have like your character, you see your character is level 2 and it's 0 XP from the 450. So if you succeed to 450, it's gonna level up. With your coins, you can buy stuff. So I can upgrade this, and after I upgrade it, it's gonna be even more expensive. So yeah, basically that. And you see my power going up because I'm getting stronger because I buy it. And then also you see the charge. I have a lot of charge. I cheated it all because I want to test something, and then it's easier to have a lot of it. So I've got basically a cheat key, and if I press the cheat key, you see I go level up. So if I do like this, you see I'm going level up, and I'd be like level 19 now. So, but you cannot do that in the real game. So if you have a look right here, I've got a crafting system. So this is an item crafter. It's gonna show you the crafting, and this it's based off Minecraft, because then you put one thing here and one thing there, and then you get an output, and then you can craft it. So if I grab this one and this one, no, not that one, this one and this, you get like a bone, and slime makes a slime bone, and now I've got a slime bone, and the slime bone and an empty glass means like slime potion. And if you have a slime potion and you put paper in it, you get a health potion. So you can basically make health potions that way, and you earn this in games. So yeah, I think that's great. So that's basically this screen, and then you have your inventory, and you see I've got a lot of items right here. I've got 7 health potions equipped. I can equip more. If I press on the item, you can see like the rarity of it. So this is rare item, this is legendary, this one is legendary, this one is common. You can see how many pieces I have of that item. Also the rare and the legendary are showing like a neat little effect over the image itself. So that's really cool. So I can sell this. And then if you sell it, you get like 900 coins. If you use it, you get like plus 5 P1 damage. And that's basically means like your attack number 1. So that's basically this one. And then, yeah, for all the things you see like explanation of what it does. But you can also get like paper, and you can transform it to your paper right here. So if you have like 6 of these right here, it's not 6 right here, you need to transfer it over, so you're gonna use it, because you can also sell it if you want money for it. And then you see like here, it's a chest icon. I can use the chest, but where is the chest gonna be? Because if you use your chest, you get the chest to open, but you cannot see it gonna open. So that's because I'm still in the tutorial. If I'm not in the tutorial, more buttons will be available right here, and I can go to the special chest menu and I can open a chest. Opening a chest takes like 3 hours real time, so it's not like you you need to play 3 hours. No, if you open the chest and I close this window, this game, and I go in 3 hours later, and I open the game up, I can open the chest. So it's also counting the time when you're not playing. So I can also sell it for like really much coins and diamonds. So I can do that too. And then, yeah, basically that's the inventory. So if you look at this, I'm getting more items if I do that. So now I'm gonna show you the level. So world 1, level 2. This is level 2. So this is snow level. The first one is green level. So this is snow level. And this is an enemy. We have different kind of enemies in each round. But all, or rave, what you want to call it. And you have each different enemies in different worlds. So I've got like 20 or 10, I don't know. It's not really much, I think. I've got a few. Let's say I've got a few enemies. So, and every enemy has different attacks. So I've got like the attack that takes me into fire. it's gonna freeze me, so I cannot do one round. So yeah, basically if I'm gonna play this, I can attack the other person. So this one is much stronger, but it has a little life, so I can kill it really fast. So I'm one killing it because I cheated, because my power is really high. So basically now I've succeeded that level, and now I've got 3 stars because I'm really good. And now I can draw 3 things, because in every level you succeed, you can draw items from it. So that's really cool, I think. Now I lost one item, because yeah, you don't get the chance to get every item you draw. So that's also a cool mechanism. And you see like all the confetti in the background. So this one is also complete. So if I complete this one, you see like I've did some effects right here. You see I've got that one right here, so I can heal up and he's gonna attack me. I can attack him back. This one can give me the potions effect. I don't know if it's gonna do it, but it can. So I'm gonna do some draws right here, and now you see I've got more levels, and you see like hard, because this level is really difficult. You see like a world boss, but the world boss is not working. If I click on it, it does nothing. Also, I've got a coral catch. This basically means like you're underwater, the coral is waving in the water, and all the damage you do to the coral, you get in coins. So it's basically 2 or 3 times a day you can do that to get a multiplier with your coins. And then you got a special reward system. You can look under the leaf you want to have. So I want to brown leaf, and then it's gonna give you something. So I've got 2 health potions and 715 coins. So I can do this 2 times and then it's gonna go away. So basically that's this. So I've got a few extra buttons right here. I've got a shop. I can buy diamonds for money, but it's only working in the Play Store. I can watch an ad to get some money. So I can watch an ad, and then the ad comes up, and I can close it, and I can do that 5 times and I get money from it. So I can basically buy items, but items are not implemented yet that I can buy. I can buy like special offers. So I can buy this for 6 euros and I get 900 diamonds, 1500 coins, 2 chests, and also 2 wheel spins. I can buy it. So and also I can buy coins for diamonds. So that's also really fun. Then we have like the wheel of the lucky wheel. And every day you've got like different rewards for the lucky wheel. So this wheel got numbers. Number 1 is basically this one. 2 is 2 and 3 is 3, etc. So you can get one of these 8 rewards for it. So 6 times the diamonds, 550 diamonds. And these are just coins, and these are real items in your inventory. And these are your spins, and now I've got really much spins because I cheated. But normally you can have like 3 spins a day, and then you, if you want to buy more, you can buy for $3, you can, or euros, you can buy more spins. And then if I spin this, I've got a chance to get one of these items. And every day is gonna be, look, I've got now 8 swords because I'm on the 6. So I've got 8 swords items. So each day it's gonna different. So in the weekends it's gonna be really good, because the weekends are happy weekends, because everyone is free usually, and then you get like extra bonuses on top of the normal rewards, because these rewards are really cool to start off with. But in the weekends it's really crazy. So that's basically this screen. So if we go to the last screen, we can go and spawn a chest. I've got 27 chests. Chests are really good loot, so I'm gonna spawn the chest. So the chest is right here. I'm gonna unlock it, and now it's gonna take 3 hours until it's unlocked. So I will cheat the system now and show you how it's showing when I'm gonna open it. So be right back in a sec. Alright, it should be working right now. So yeah, if you have a look, this is the thingy that's gonna show up when you have waited 3 hours. So if I'm opening the chest, you see like I've got the reward right here. So this is random for every chest you open. And a fun fact about this is when you press spawn chests, it's gonna decide what you're gonna get before you open it up. Or it's the other way around. It's gonna decide. I don't know. It's gonna decide it when you open the chest up. So that's basically really fun because it's always random. And sometimes it's better than other times. But I try to have it like non-pay to win, you know. A lot of games on the stores are pay to win. And I really, really hate that. So this is actually really good. So I've got basically the basics of this. And then you can go like so. And then you spawn a new chest and you can unlock it. So yeah, it has a little sweet animation. And I think that's really good. So I'm really glad with this, actually. I've also made this in another project, and I can copy and paste it for every project I want to have this option too. So that's really cool. I think that's really cool. So yeah, basically that's it. And I've got a few levels right here. So this is Ice King. If I go like this, then he's dead. But he's also dead. I want to show you a little effect he can do. Yeah, so if you have a look, I was frozen and he can attack 2 times and I cannot attack because I'm in the frozen state of it. So he can freeze people. So I think that's really cool. Also, I have the same with fire. Fire you can attack, but you get more damage every second. So basically, it's a bit difficult when you have that and you are low health. Also, the enemy progression, some enemies will be really strong in the end. So some enemies are not really strong, but some enemies are really strong. And they are getting smarter and better in the game also. So I hope to show you now the potions effect, if I can do that. I've got not many health potion left, so. No, I don't think I'm gonna get it. So, yeah, you see, I can also miss an attack. Even though I'm really powerful, I can also have attack missed. So, that was really fast, actually. But I use my special power to get that sword around, that knife. That's basically special power. So you have, like, mana on the top left. And then if you go, like, a few times, you can have more mana, and when you have more mana, more powers will be available. And how more mana you have, or more powerful the attacks are. So I think that's really cool. So yeah, basically that's the game. I can show you. Oh, this level don't actually work yet. So that's kind of strange. I think I don't have that programmed in, but yeah. I can show you a little bit of the code now. I don't want to show you everything because if people gonna copy and paste this, you can basically have free things. So I don't really want that because I put a lot of work in this and this actually really good. So I've got like an engine object right here, and the engine object is basically where I put the variables in. That has like these variables in the game, and checks for the weekday, the current date, and then the in level stats of the character. It's been a long time since I opened up the code of this, so I'm also a bit confused on what it's doing when it's gonna load. So the enemy statics. So these are like for every enemy. You can see like the health points and the attack points. and then the all-in-one PowerPoint. So yeah, that's basically an easier way for me to use it in the game itself and to make more enemies. I've got an enemy spawner in each round, in each level, and I can configure every level from here. Also, I've got like the win reward system that I see, like when the machine is selected at 5, I can do like give this item and then a random amount, and the random amount is like 1, 2, 3. So yeah, that's actually that system to choose which one is gonna do it and wanna give you. So I've got like a system for checking the stars and how good you are in the game. And that's basically, I've got a lot of systems for it. So I've got the world map is also is checking every second if you're gonna drag it, and then have limits to the screen ratio of the game. So if I'm gonna show you the menu for it. So this is basically the whole map, and then it's gonna check that it's not gonna go out of the map, so you can so it's always fitting into the screen. And then basically this is the checking system of the points into the map. So you see like the levels, if it's gonna go above this, it's gonna disappear, because then the performance will be better. If I have all the objects right here and I want to draw it into the game, then it's maybe gonna lag on older systems. But if you go like up, it's gonna handle it for you and display only things that needs to be displayed. So I want to have like a system that's optimized your FPS for it. So I think that is really cool. So yeah, I've got like every system is marked with the map. So I've got an ad system. So this ad system is just like the duration of the ad, the scene ad, the ad clicks are all variables I can edit. So I can check on that. So basically, if I see the ad for this amount of time, the 15 ticks, the game ticks, then the ad will be set to scene and also to done. And then like when I press on the ad itself, it's gonna give me even more diamonds and coins for it back, because I not only have accepted to see an ad, but also clicked on it to download it potentially. So yeah, basically it's gonna direct you to the store if it's gonna find the chosen app. So yeah, that's basically the ad system. And I have much more systems, but I'm yeah, I think the video is long enough and you get a little bit of knowledge of how this all works. So in the next video I will show you the real game I'm working on right now. It's actually my first multiplayer game that goes over the network. So networking is actually really, really difficult, and I've learned it a few months ago, but I'm getting better in it, and I want to make a really good multiplayer game, and it's a little bit of a special game. So I'm gonna show you that in the next video. So I hope you enjoy this video, and I see you in the next video. So have a great day. I see you later. Take care. Bye bye.